modern microelectronic devices, solar cells, and ultra-thin invisible corrosion-resistant coatings are prepared by using an exciting technique called atomic layer deposition, or shortly, ALD. This method allows to deposit thin films of a variety of materials by taking advantage of sequential chemical processes that occur in a specially designed ALD reactor. The most important components of an ALD reactor that uses gas phase chemicals are shown in this simplified model. A thermocouple and computer-controlled heaters are used to ensure a desired deposition temperature. The growth of the deposited film can be monitored with an oscillating quartz crystal. The chemicals that are used for the deposition are called precursors and enter the reaction chamber along with the carrier gas. A vacuum pump is used to ensure a low pressure and that the reaction byproducts and precursor leftovers are removed. The precursors enter the reaction chamber one at a time and react with the substrate in a self-limiting manner. As the substrate is repeatedly exposed to different precursors, a thin film of desired material is deposited in each cycle. The thickness of the final film depends on the number of the cycles. An easy example would be the deposition of titanium dioxide on a silicon substrate. By using titanium chloride and water as precursors and nitrogen as carrier gas. In this process, the deposition cycle consists of four steps. In the first step, titanium chloride is inserted into the chamber, and that reacts with the hydroxyl groups on the substrate surface, forming the first layer. As a result, hydrogen chloride is produced, as some chloride are removed from the titanium chloride and hydrogen from the hydroxyl group. The excess titanium chloride and hydrogen chloride are then removed from the chamber in the second step by purging with the carrier gas. In the third step, the second precursor, water, is inserted into the chamber, and that reacts with the titanium chloride on the surface. As a result, chloride is replaced with oxygen and titanium dioxide is formed. Finally, in the fourth step, the excess water and hydrogen chloride are purged from the chamber with nitrogen, leaving behind the first layer of titanium dioxide. By repeating this cycle, a film with desired thickness can be deposited. The film growth can be monitored with a quartz crystal microbalance. If a material is deposited on the quartz crystal during the ALD process, then its mass slightly increases, and that causes a measurable drop in its oscillation frequency. This method is so sensitive that it allows to monitor even the individual steps in an atomic layer deposition cycle. The structure of the deposited film depends on the substrate's temperature. For example, amorphous films can be obtained at low temperatures, and crystallic films at higher temperatures. The structure also depends on the substrate material and on the thickness of the deposited layer. One of the greatest benefits of ALD is the possibility of applying an uniform, continuous coating with a well-defined thickness, structure, and chemical composition on sophisticated, three-dimensional substrates. For example, this method can even be used to coat the walls of nanoporous templates. And if the template is later removed, then nanotubes with desired wall thickness can be obtained. Over the last two decades, the applications for atomic layer deposition have dramatically increased, and the first devices based on this nanotechnology have already found their way to our everyday life. You just learned more about the basics of atomic layer deposition. Be sure to subscribe and watch the other mini lectures as well.